business success that come across, you know, thousands of people that I've done, you know, what is it that makes somebody really good? Because I'm trying to figure out who do I give more responsibility to, how do you determine who to hire, and the drive is the number one thing. It's more important than intelligence. It's more important than, I would say, education. It's actually more important than experience. All those are important, but drive is really what sets people apart. And I assume, unless you're the one who watched video games all day and got straight in, and that's 4.0 when you don't have, you know, I'm like either. Unless you're one of that, probably you're driven. But don't forget to drive. And I tried to define what drive is. Here's what I came up with. The combination of a commitment to accomplish goals and the determination, persistence, and will to succeed. So a combination of a commitment to accomplish goals, you gotta have goals, we're going to find that, but determination, persistence, and will to succeed. Now I've seen people, one of the most successful people in our company, doesn't have a college education, but the guy is driven, you know, and he's very intelligent, he didn't go to have a college education, but a very driven guy, and he has accomplished a lot because of the drive. Turns out that most great accomplishments in life are actually accomplished by really ordinary people that just work hard. I mean, it's not like you're born brilliant and everything, right? And so you think about all the great people out there that have accomplished all these great things. You kind of you read a little bit of story in my previous video. But people who have done great things are actually kind of normal people that just committed themselves to something. They found a way and they went after it and they had that drive. What's the cost of money? You know, you've got to spend over $1,000 to get the light bulb right. You know, not that Edison wasn't a brilliant guy, but $1,000 probably did more than his natural brilliance. Because if you go with natural brilliance, it's not the first time, right? It's a drive that can make happen. So some quotes on this one. Abraham Lincoln, our 16th president. This quote, always bear in mind that your resolution to succeed is more important than any other thing. Pretty strong from his day. This one's from Alexander Hamilton. He's one of our founding fathers. He had a key role in creating the Constitution. He wrote the majority of those papers. Here's his quote. Men give me credit for genius. All the genius I have lies in this. When I have a subject in hand, I study it profoundly. Day and night it is before me. I explore it in all of its bearings. My mind becomes pervaded with it. Then the effort I make, the people are pleased to call the fruit of genius. It is the fruit of labor and thought. So I'm kind of picking up an old guy from 1700 where he is, but you can kind of get the point there. And then Calvin Coolidge, our 30th president, this quote, a famous one, nothing in the world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than successful men with talent. Oh, excuse me, nothing is more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Nothing in the world can take the place of resistance. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Venus will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone are omnipotent. The slogan, press on, has solved, and will always solve problems with the universe. So I'm saying, drive, persistence is really what does it. Next one, number four, be passionate. And I kind of alluded to this in my opening little comments, trying to see if you help me to accomplish my goals and kind of get into it. I think one of the key sayings, so obvious, is the more you put into something, the more you get out of it. That concept is more, it's so true, relates to everything in life. And, you know, it's kind of folks that don't really make the effort, then they end up complaining about how that activity was a waste of time and they got nothing out of it, because they went into it not expecting to get anything out of it. And so, the more you put into it, the more you'll get out of it. And it makes the action more meaningful to you, then it brings you better results. And you'll find over time that joy is actually in the case more than it is in accomplishing the goal. And, you know, it's, I think back to the early days when you weren't successful and I was working like a dog. That was really fun. You had that chase. That was actually, in some ways, more fun than after you kind of made it and And then you're out there looking, you're actually trying to recapture that passion about a new business or a new activity, you get back that feeling of going after it. And so the joy is definitely in your face. And so the key is to find something that you're passionate about. And the easiest way to become passionate about something is to actually do something you love. And it's talked about a lot. So my family of people, you know exactly what you want to do and you find that kind of quickly in your career. But that would be the exception if you're one of them. So it's more about trying a lot of things. And I've had people ask me, what should I do with my first job? It's really important what my first job is. And my thing is, like, it isn't that. You know what your first job is? It's your first job. You know? That's what it is. You're getting a second job, a third job. And so the key is to get a first job and then do the best you can at that job. And if you find out you're having a hard time being passionate about it, you won't get another job. So grappling with things, I forced myself, I found myself, I trained myself to become passionate about things I don't really care about. Because I've learned that, you know, certain things in life you have to do to get accomplish your goal. So it might be something you're naturally passionate about because it's just you feel it. There are other things that you don't really feel it, you know you've got to accomplish. So for me, I feel accomplishment, it's my dedicated degree, I want to get out of this place, I want to conquer the world, whatever. So I go to summer school, my friends are out having fun, and I'm going to summer school classes. So I was into it. I was into it because I figured, you know, I get into this. Because that's your phrase, I'm going to do it. It's incredibly important in my business. I'm going to find a way to actually get this. This professor gave me extra credits, so I can get out of it too. But that's why I was passionate about it. I forced myself to be passionate about it, because I knew it would help me get the goal. I kind of hated it, to be honest, but I got excited about it. So you try to find activities that are required to accomplish your goal, get excited about it. If they're not required to accomplish your goal, your vision, don't do it. Find a way to get out of it. Go back and constantly think about what you're doing. Don't just kind of do whatever it is, just go with God, whatever it tells you to do. All right, this one kind of relates to the fifth goal. It's a nice transition to the fifth goal. We talk about being passionate and putting your best effort forward. This fifth point is maintain a positive attitude. So it kind of relates to it. Basically, be a glass half full person. You know what I mean by that? You know, glass half empty or glass half full. Look on the bright side. I found that positive people are always much more productive than negative people. And so I'll try to find it out through a very quick interview process. It's kind of your outlook, your draws, your positive or negative. It's amazing how differently two people can see the exact same situation. And we have some that see problems as opportunities to overcome, so they like problems. I try to say to our companies, you know, I like bad news because good news is that it. What do you do about good news? Celebrate? That's great. Good news, love it. Okay, well, how can I actually add value? It's not that fun. I'd rather have bad news than I can solve a problem because it's fun to actually solve a problem. So you look for the problem, you see those opportunities to improve yourself and make a difference in business, I think in life in general. The harder something is, the better off you are. Because if it's really hard and nasty, it's hard for the other guy to figure it out. And the average person is lazy. So the average person is going to shy away from the really hard and nasty stuff. So when you see a hard situation, a tough problem to solve, latch onto it. If you solve it, you're going to make yourself unique. You go with the easy stuff, you're going to go